This by far is the most outstanding video you'll ever see as an African or a person of African descent that the Western world has been trying to hide for centuries. Welcome to Tunachiki's Africa React. I am your host, Mikey Mushi, and this is a show where we go online and look at viral videos concerning the African continent and its people. And in today's video, we will be talking about one of the most important thing, what it means to be African and the difference between being black and being African, because one is made up, the other one is an actual fact. So today's video, we will be reacting to this geneticist. He's a British geneticist called Dr. Adam Rutherford, and he says something very important that every African here, every African in the diaspora, and every person who has an inch of African DNA needs to hear. Okay, this is something the Western media will never tell you. This is something the Western world will never tell you. So before we start with our reaction, please make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. It's the best way to let YouTube know this is a good video, and it will share it to more like-minded people like you. So let's have a listen, and afterwards we'll discuss.
The average African-American genome is very distinct from the African genomes from which they were taken. Now, you couple that with the fact that there is more genetic diversity within the African continent than in the rest of the world put together.
Have you heard that? Just very, very important thing, what he's just said there.
Which means that, on average, someone from Senegal is more different genetically to someone from Angola than either of those people are to anyone else on the rest of the planet. And that's just what the genetics says. So I know this is quite a brain scrambling concept.
No, I'm with you.
But this is one of the problems.
Okay, are you with us? Just bear with him. He'll explain it perfectly.
This is one of the problems with the earlier conversation about how we categorize people. We say black people, right? Because Linnaeus said black people, Homo sapiens afer, or Africanus. But actually, it's a completely incoherent biological category because of the amount of genetic diversity that exists in people from who are in Africa or from the African diasporas. So how this relates to the transatlantic slave trade means that you've got two people taken from maybe neighboring tribes or counties or whatever the equivalent is, or countries, who are taken from their birthplace, put onto ships, mixed around, they live or die, they then traded around, forcibly mated potentially. We know from the genetics now that there is a lot of European DNA in the African American genome, and mostly it is from male Europeans into female African Americans. So, you know, figure that out.
He's politely saying sex slaves.
Interestingly, the converse is also true. Many white Americans have up to 20% of African ancestry that we can measure in their DNA. So again, it's another example of how...
There's a mixed race Medici.
Okay, so we will stop it there. But please, we will link the original podcast because it goes on for about 2 hours and it's just pure gold. What he's talking about is just pure gold. And this long form, for you to understand everything he's saying about genetics, African DNA, African genetics, you really have to watch the 1 hour, 2 hours podcast, and so you can educate and elevate yourself, right? But with that, let's discuss on the points that the good doctor has said, right? First, he said, which is the most important thing, and which no Western media organization, which no Western platform can always tell you, because these Western media platforms like putting Africans and people of African descent down, right? They just like to propagate Western white supremacy, right? Because white supremacy is just Western supremacy. That's the job of the media. So the thing this media will never tell you is that your African DNA, right? Your African DNA. You, me as a Kenyan, me as a Tanzanian, are like so genetically diverse more than the rest of the world combined. Like, you can imagine how, like, what that one means, right? So think about DNA as juice, right? So you have concentrated juice, and over time it keeps diluting it, right? It keeps diluting. So what the doctor is saying, maybe to explain it in a layman's term, is that the African juice is the most concentrated one that has more variety, like more variations, right? So that's why me as a Kenyan and a Senegalese, me as a Kenyan or somebody from South Sudan or somebody from Egypt are vastly different genetically as compared to the rest of the people, as compared to a European, a Spanish person, a Portuguese person, French person, German person, British person, basically the same DNA lineage, right? Technically, you know, this topic is kind of complicated because I'm not an expert and I'm explaining this as a layman. So bear with me if I don't get it quite right scientifically, right? But the way I've understood it is that me as a Kenyan, right, and my friend as a South Sudanese, we are more genetically different, more genetically diverse than a Portuguese, a Spanish, a German, a Russian, a Belgian, right? All those people are more similar. Like, the difference between them is negligible than the difference between me as a Kenyan, me, my friend as a Senegalese, my friend as a South Sudanese, right? So what does that tell you about what this world is? The whole concept of being black is fake. It's made up. It's man-made, right? Because nature does not care if I'm black, if I'm what. Nature cares if I'm African, genetically, right? Because DNA always wants to spread and propagate, right? That's the whole point of life on this planet. So this DNA of ours, African DNA, doesn't care if these Western people call us black, doesn't care if these Western people call themselves white, because they're not white and we're not black. We are where we came from, right? The region where we came from, our DNA is where we came from, right? So all this media trying to push the fact that these black people categorizing Africans together, right? Like all, if you've got black skin, you're the same person. No. Technically, it should be, if you have white skin, you're more of the same person. But if you have African DNA, you're more different. You're more diverse than your brother. Like, even the next country, the next tribe, me as a Bantu, my friend as a Kushite, my other friend as a Nilot, we are genetically diverse, and those people live next to each other, right? The Maasai, the Kikuyu, the Luyas, right? These are the communities in East Africa, right? Those people live next door to each other, and they're more diverse than an American and a Russian, right? Yeah, they're more diverse than a white Australian and a British person, because they're technically the same people, right? So what does that tell you about the world that we live in? We live in a white supremacy, a Western supremacy world, where they put down African people by categorizing them and demeaning them, right? Everything black, as Julius Malema recently said, everything black on the world we live in is vilified. Everything black is hated, right? Because they gave us this thing, you guys hold this black thing, we hate this black thing. And the retort is that technically, scientifically, we are not black, we are African. And African means like a Tuareg from Algeria, right? South Sudanese from South Sudan, right? Pygmy from DR Congo, Khoisan from South Africa. Those people genetically, we even did a recent video where Neil deGrasse Tyson was talking about the same things, right? Those two people have got the most extreme genetic characteristics and are, like, in this, the world that we live in, are considered as the same people, which is totally insane. Even the doctor, like, says the lunacy, right? How these scientists can be like, you people are black. Like, as a geneticist, I'm sure people like that always think we live in a crazy world, right? Where people make scientific, political decisions, scientific decisions, policies, like decisions based on racial stereotypes, based on racial hatred, based on racial looks, right? Just because you look a certain way, this person already thinks you are this step and this step and this step. And the genetics speak a different story, right? And he also mentioned about how there's a lot of white people with 20% African DNA. So some of you racist people out there in America who hate Africans technically are actually are Africans, right? And this is what the media will never tell you, because they want to vilify this African DNA to put us down so that they can be up. That's the whole definition of white supremacy, of Western supremacy, which is basically the same thing, right? They're making their decisions the same way the Nazis made their decisions with the Aryan race, right? It wasn't based on science. It wasn't based on fact. It was based on this pseudoscience called eugenics, racism, right? So how can you have the same moral compass as a Nazi and be like, oh yeah, we are the modern civilized world, and you're just perpetuating the same decision making, the same category making, the same behaviors. Technically the worst people to ever exist on this planet did. You're basically following what the Nazis did in categorizing people, saying, "Ah, we are better off because we are like this, and you guys are not better off because you're like that, because you're all black in this area, right? And we'll have better policies for us, and you'll have poor policies for you people, right?" These are the same people who always vilify the Nazis, yet they're just using the same policies as the Nazis to run this apparently modern world, right? Yeah. So sorry for the long rant, but this is always very important to me, this topic, because I love fact. I'm always a geek. I always love science, and science cannot lie, right? Science tells the truth. Even if you're racist, you can try to put on in your pseudoscience, which over the history they've done, but the truth always comes out. Facts are always facts, regardless of if you're racist or not. Facts will always be facts. So to all my Africans, please, I would recommend you guys from today, if you're in America, if you're in the UK, if you're in Australia, all over the world, right? If you're in the continent, stop referring to yourself as black, right? Start referring to yourself as African, right? African of maybe for me, I can be like of Bantu descent, of the East African region, right? Stop using their terminology. Stop using their racist categories, right? Start just using the facts, right? You can even start calling yourself Amazonians, Azanias, like, but don't just perpetuate the things that you're told, black, white. Yeah, those are made up words, right? So, with that said, this has been your host, Mekimushi. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. It's the best way to support this channel. Yeah, and with that said, always remember, Africa is watching.